Hey guys, my name is Puffy Between, and this is Rotation Recommendations, the show where I take you through Smite's free rotation and give my thoughts and feelings on the characters in the current meta. We've got a tough week ahead of us, and I went purely off tier list for this one. Coming in at number 5 is a hunter with a very steep learning curve. Ulla, the Glorious One, is a mana-hungry, combo-dependent hunter that, in the hands of a master, is simply beautiful to see in action. But new players will struggle with his kit without some serious practice. Typically found in the duo lane, but can also be occasionally found in the solo lane, and is one of the few hunters who could have some potential in the jungle. In true Norse fashion, he is a stance switcher, allowing him to switch between melee and ranged attacks at will, something that is completely unique to Ulla. Ulla is by no means a weak pick, but he suffers from a lack of innate CC immunity in a meta where CC rules the roost, but he has buttloads of damage and versatility to make up for it. These next three were all rough to place. Mercury is a high damage poke focused assassin, and 3.8 gave him a lot of new tools to play with. Odin's utility comes and goes with metas and is seeing some drop off, and Raijin's high damage and utility is absurd and should be considered a safe pick, but often gets focused in the middle of teamfights. So I said fuck it and placed them all fourth. So let's just go through them and give you guys a quick overview of what these gods are capable of. First up is Mercury, a Roman assassin with one job, fisting you in your squishy butthole. A crit and movement speed based assassin who enjoys punching things once or twice in order to kill it. It's just a shame I can never crit with him. Mercury enjoys the new Bloodforge and Wind Demon that came in the 3.8 patch, as well as a resurgence of the speed buff. Hi-Rez just really wants Mercury to be viable again, man. The last thing I'm going to say about Mercury is stop building attack speed on him. He doesn't need it. Please, stop it. Thank you. Odin flutters in and out of metas, usually when low mobility healers like Hel, Aphro, and Sylvanas are popular, but is often used as a counterpick option to gods like Vermana, Chiron, and Guan Yu. Odin gameplay usually consists of burr bombs until the damage is no longer one-shotting nerds in the early game, and ulting literally on cooldown in the late game. Odin is typically found either as a support or a jungle, where his damage and utility is a little more useful than in the solo lane. Finally on this selection is Raijin, a Japanese utility mage with retarded amounts of damage, good mobility, clear and control. So what does Raijin lack? I don't know what it is, but it's something since he consistently loses in SPL games, often gets shut down by junglers and is the target in most teamfights. Plus, I don't like playing him, but that's irrelevant. Honestly, take your pick with any of the three gods I just mentioned and see what works for you. Coming in at number 1 this week is a god that, once again, I suck at, but I'm always happy to see one on my team. Geb is hard. As rock. Honestly, you could take away all of Geb's kit and leave him with a shield, and he'd still be good. Geb has a line dash dingy, a cone knockup, the shield of zero fucks, and the ultimate that never kills. It is widely believed that Smite is currently dominated by the early game. Which it is, as a poor start starts you on the road to disaster. But when games are currently going on for more than 30 minutes on average, it is strange that Geb, one of the best late game supports, isn't seeing much playtime. And that's it for rotation recommendations. Let me know who you're going to be picking up, and I'll see you guys next week. Peace out.